going from one campsite to another. And I was in the Daily Mail as man with Lilo. But that's my embarrassing story. You got any lads?
I don't think I've got any. I can't think.
Next question.
Laura Seaton has asked if she can buy us a pint when we do with the rescheduled gig in Newcastle at the Sage.
Kurt will have four Peronis.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kurt will have all our beer for us. Nice one. Gareth Eccleston, how did you decide on the band name?
Fucking hell.
That was mine.
I'll see you in an hour.
It was basically seeing the room called Special Needs when I went on a tour of high school. And I thought that was weird that somebody could be put in a room and taken out of the mainstream of education. But we're council estate kids, really, or at least most of us are. And it's a bit of a sort of two fingers up and sort of celebration of the underdog, really. Slow Readers Club are underdogs, don't underestimate us, that kind of thing. What else have we got? Okay, Nicola Gibson, when you all have different visions of how a song should sound, how do you work through it? Do you ever work on multiple versions to see what sounds best?
We have a song and we like it, or if we don't like it, if we like it, we'll stick with it. But yeah, we don't all have different versions. We just find one where we all agree on it, and some of us might like another version, or not a version, but some of us might like to try another idea in a certain way. We might try ideas, but we all have to be happy with the song before we record it or before we play it live, because you know, some are happier than others. But if one of us completely really really hates a tune, then we won't go anywhere with it.
I think that came from when we did the Twitter listening party. I talked about every word being a difficult one to finish on, if you know what I mean, like decide what the sound of it should be. So that's probably come from that, but I think the producer opted out in that instance. Tom Monaghan, what's your favourite Slow Readers album? Mine's probably Cavalcade. I should say the last one, really, shouldn't I? But mine's Cavalcade, our second one.
The new one.
Say that, bro. I said the new one.
The best of the Slow Readers Club.
The joy of the return.
Yeah, I'd say the new one.
There you go. I think all the others are turning you on. Where? Okay. What's your favourite previous performance, or any previous Kendal Calling performance?
What's your favourite, Jim?
Our first one.
We had a standing bass player called Chris on the first time we played Kendal Calling, and at the time
I was away. I think it was in America, running or something like that. So I couldn't play the gig. So we got someone in to play for me, and these always say it was their best ever gig. I'm sure it was.
Up to that point, it probably was.
It was my best ever gig. It was my best ever gig. It was
dead easy. I think he was good.
That's odd.
Why is it echoing or something?
I can't hear anything.
Back on now, guys. Sorry.
Right.
Okay. Can you still see me? Because it's sort of brought up
I can see you.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, we're all there. Yeah.
Sound okay. Where was I? What's your favorite and least favorite thing about self isolating?
Shit.
I've used a drill. That's the first.
Is that your favorite or least favorite though?
At the time, it was my least favorite, but now I feel very,
you're satisfied
with myself. So I've still got two more things to put up with it. So we'll see.
My, sorry, Jim, go on.
No, you go, mate. You go, you're the singer.
My favourite thing is probably spending more time with my kids. My least favourite thing is spending more time with my kids.
I'd say my favourite thing is not having a plan for the next day. Not that I have plans for the day, but just, you know, you get up and you think, whatever, just fucking whatever happens, happens. But even though I like staying in, I hate knowing that I can't go out. That's what pisses me off. So even though I wouldn't, like, let's say we weren't isolated now and nobody was on a lockdown, I probably wouldn't move out of the house anyway. But now I know I can't go out, it pisses me off. So,
it is,
yeah.
Annoying.
That's mine.
Next question, one sec. What was the most fun song to record on Joy of the Return?
Probably Killing Me for me, from a drumming point of view anyway. It was the most fun I've had drumming, recording a song. But they all had issues, didn't they? Like, in terms of just like the days, we did a song a day.
Yeah. I think The Wait was probably the easiest because we'd done it that much live. So that probably felt the most natural, which is the last track on the album.
First track we recorded on the album, though. So.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Strange way.
I think I enjoyed messing about with pedals and stuff more than actually recording parts, particularly more getting sounds.
Yeah, it was topping. We were recording in Par Street. There was loads of toys to play with and stuff. One night it was good. Let's have a look. Do you remember playing Friars Court in Warrington in 2013?
Yeah.
that might have been my first gig.
Yeah, it's the little stage out in the courtyard, actually. It was.
Yeah, I remember that.
I remember
we went to Weatherspoons or something over the road and had something to eat, I think.
No, you played it a couple of times. I played it twice, right. You played it before me as well.
Right, there you go. Yeah, that was the better gig.
it felt a bit big time, that, because I remember there being like more lights than we were used to and stuff like that, and we're on a stage and it was above people. So at the time it was...
I know more than one person there.
Let's see if there's anything on Facebook actually that's come in just now.
It's a good silence, this.
Yeah, one, sorry.
Dead air is a crime.
it is one for you. Who inspires you to be who you are today?
Oh, fucking hell.
Somebody inspires
you. You don't have to say me, David. Yeah.
It's like The Office, isn't it? Reddy's doing the appraisals. Who inspires you? No, not your parents. That was a given. Don't know. I think
it's a tricky one, that, isn't it?
Yeah, who inspires you to be who you are? I think, like, just as a person, I think most people would just say the parents or, you know, the relatives, the brothers or sisters or whatever. So, but for me, like, not that I've got perfect manners, but manners and all that sort of stuff, I think that just comes from my dad or my mum. And then wanting to be in a band, my brother didn't inspire me as such. He just bought a guitar when we were kids. And then... whatever he had, I wanted one of those things. He was 4 years, he's 4 years older than me. So if he had a computer or whatever, I wanted one. If he had a bike, I wanted one. He got a guitar, I wanted one. He joined a band, I wanted to join a band. So it's that sort of stuff. Whereas now, you know, he's flipped around. He sees everything we're doing in the band and he loves it and he can't get enough of it. So, but yeah, I'd say he sort of inspired me to be in a band. But as people think, parents and all that, innit? Really deep answer, that, wasn't it?
Jim. So Jamie didn't want to be a Premiership footballer, innit?
No, yeah, it is. He didn't like it.
Yeah, I think when I first started listening to music and stuff, it's a terrible cliche, but it was Lennon. John Lennon was a big thing, and I thought his sort of philosophy on life and everything was the business, until I sort of read that he was he was a more difficult character than the sort of hippie that you see as the stereotype. But yeah, Lennon was a big influence on me, I think. Any more influences, lads?
I'm probably similar to Jim's in a way. My brother was in a band, had a drum kit. That's kind of what inspired me to want to, you know, have a go on the drums. But other than that, it's your parents and family, isn't it?
Yeah.
How long does it actually take you to read books?
I'll be honest. I've read one book that I've read.
Bravo, 2-0.
Excluding the ones that you have to read in school. I've read like Lord of the Flies in school and Macbeth and stuff like that. But I've read Bravo 2-0 by Andy McNabb. that's the only book I've ever read off my own back.
Actually, impressive.
And it was good. And you know, like when people say, the book's better. So like someone watches Harry Potter or whatever, and then you'll have people go, oh, you should read the books. It's miles better. Then you just go, no, they're not. But the book, Bravo 2-0, was better than the BBC film they made with Sean Bean. So it's true. But you know, someone writes a book called Die Hard, and then I'd rather watch the film, if I'm honest, because I want to see John McClane in his vest running around and saving a Nakatomi Plaza. I don't want to have to imagine it. There you go. I've read one book.
I tried to read two books on the last tour in Ireland, but I got about 10 pages in, gave up.
I was the same. I played on my Switch instead. But I did read when I was at uni, like in college. But don't read so much these days. There you go. That's the book section done with.
No readers book.
What is the design on the album cover? I'd worked on the design because that used to be my day job before we started doing music full time. And the actual shape is like a paper sculpture. And it was taken from an artist called Ruth Pestle, who I've got in contact with, having seen it on Instagram. And then just worked on it, worked some typography over the top and put some colour behind it. And then that was the finished thing. Bit of pink stands out on iTunes and all that business. So, yeah. And then there's a few more questions. Are you writing music remotely at the moment? Are we writing at home? We've shared a couple of ideas so far, haven't we? Played a bit. Yeah. I've like played a bit on piano, and Kurt's done bits of guitar work and that. And
that didn't work.
Yeah, try to. Yeah,
we tried practicing, didn't we, the other day? Yeah. But it's too much. It's too much like lag and stuff, and you can't stay in time or anything like that. It's hard work.
But you
can probably tell by this. Yeah, but we're sharing ideas and stuff like that. But it's hard because when we write songs, we tend to write songs together, and it's just really hard to play together on the internet because of the lag and the delay. So we're not like, you know, like in Oasis, Noel would just bring a tune to the band and then they put it together and there's a song, because we don't work like that. It's difficult, but we still swap ideas. So we'll try. It depends how long this lasts for.
Yeah.
So if our next album is shit, it's because of this.
Just sound like a lot of unfinished ideas.
Yeah. That's the name of the album. There you go.
Yeah. What albums or artists are you guys currently listening to?
The only latest one I've listened to is Tame Impala. That's the only modern thing, I think.
I've been listening to Lathams, a band I've been listening to that are doing all right. Got young lads from Wigan.
I can't say I've listened to any new music.
Yeah, I'm similar.
Does it have to be new? Is that the question? I don't know.
I haven't listened to any music.
It does say new.
Yeah. Well,
everybody else on the Kendal Calling lineup.
I've got a new dab radio on the kitchen floor. I listen to Heart 80s. Yeah, Heart 80s. So that, to me, that's new music because my radio's new. So I was listening to Topal this morning. Tears for Fears.
This one might be easier than what are our favourite TV shows?
The Office or Alan Partridge.
Only
Blackadder, probably.
Family Guy's a universal one, yeah. Isn't it?
I used to like Jules Holland. But,
yeah.
Gone off that since I've been in a band.
I've been watching the Better Call Saul recently. That's decent. Some good stuff on Netflix. And what's the first thing you're going to do when all this is over?
Open.
Bot lion.
Stay in.
Yeah, chill, I'll stay at home.
Does that go to the pub?
Yeah.
hopefully, the first thing we do is say, right, you know, we've got some gigs next week. We've got some gigs whenever, but we don't know. I think the first thing you do depends how long this lasts for, doesn't it? You know, if it was to end in a month, then I don't know. But if it was to end in 6 months, then you'd probably go out and have a big party, wouldn't you? I don't know. Yeah. I just
you'd be scared to go outside if it ended in 6 months.
Yeah, I just hope we get through it, man.
Yeah.
Obviously, if we're getting in practice, that'd be the first thing we'd do, isn't it?
Yeah. Go write the next album. Right, I think that's all the questions we've had. So, cheers for joining us, everyone. Check out our music at theslowreadersclub.co.uk and hopefully see you at Kendal. Cheers.
Buzz in. See ya.
Cheers.
Bye.